you see arriving on site. ID Lotus digging, the barge. They're going to dig around the vessel. We've moved ahead somewhat on the time frame. It's now January 93. We are moving into the salvage of the winery. This is the very beginning. First piece of equipment to arrive on site. The barge has been towed by Kevin Clark's Grimalda. It's been a long, slow trip up from the Harbour Basin. And here they are just sliding quietly under the town bridge. Barge and digger are just starting to arrive on site. We're just south of the winery. This morning there was a blessing given by the Maori people of Whanganui to the unearthing of the winery. And that was the first thing that happened before the barge arrived. And that seems to have started everything falling nicely into place. Here we see the digger starting to position itself on site. His job is going to be to dig down both sides of the vessel and remove the mud off the top of winery so it's completely surrounded by water once again, and not the mud. Here we see them lifting what they call the spuds, which are large temporary piles which attach the barge to the roof. The riverbed so it doesn't move around while they're digging. Oh dear, we've had a whoops. One of the spuds has fallen into the river. This is the second one. I hope this one goes into the right hole. We were very lucky. Greg Cox came along. Thank you very much, Greg. And dived down and attached the chain to the spud we lost. And we lifted it back up out of the river. And the barge has now got its spuds down. And he's just getting into that final bit of positioning over winery. Roy Harkness in the foreground is standing right next to the boiler. Just getting that vessel settled down. You see our chairman, Mark Campbell, he's just marking out the edge of the boat so the digger operator knows exactly where the side is so he doesn't do any damage while he's digging. Last spud goes into place. Now we're on with the business of digging up the winery. The first shovel full of mud. Members of the Fire Brigade Social Club have arrived on site, and along with trust members, and with the loan of this fire engine from the Wanganui Fire Brigade, we're starting to actually pump the mud out of the inside of the vessel. The digger's done its job, it's dug right round the outside and it's skimmed off as much of the mud from the top as we can possibly skim off without doing any damage to the deckings. And we're now getting ready to clean the mud out of inside.
Of the Whanganui River. It's the 6th of January 1993 and the official salvage on the Waimarie is well underway. The men down there you see now, they were standing on her decks right on the stern of the boat, and they're starting to pick up bits of wire and steel and odd bits that have just been sort of thrown in the river and settled on top. That's probably a stanchion that he's just picked up there, one of the, used to hold up the handrails. Yeah, just throw it ashore. Another bit of boat comes out of the river. The view you see now, the men, what they're doing is washing off the decks, and they're right on the stern of the vessel, and they'll come up towards the bow, come up river, quietly wash it off as today's tide is falling away. We're in spring tides at the moment, so as the week goes on, we'll be getting more and more of a view of the boat as the water will get lower and lower. They're just quietly working their way around now, feeling their way, getting used to being on top of it. That pole that he's just touching there, that's down the side of the vessel. They're just disturbing all the water, all the mud inside, turning it to slurry so it can wash out. The idea is to replace all the mud inside with just water.
Here we see the Type A ejector, which is a large water power pumping device. Beginning to do it. So what we're going to do with this is, it's a specialised piece of fire brigade equipment, and what we're doing with this is we're actually sucking all the mud out of the inside of the vessel. We're going to work this through compartment by compartment. You can tell when they're getting plenty of mud going through, the discharge changes to a very black colour. And they're just getting it set up on the first of the forward holds.
See the muddy water coming out now, can't you?
First time that you can actually see the boat. On the film, the tide's running out and we've started to clear a lot of mud off the top. If you look to the right hand side of the shot, a lot of the boat's sticking up. There's a boiler out in the centre and the combings in the engine room, and the edge of the vessel itself. Really good view of the vessel now. See Ian, forward there, just sitting on the edge of the deck. Brian walking about on top of the deck. There's a boiler out there in the centre. We've attached a lot of lines and turfers and things to the boat now that we can see a bit more of it. And the guys are starting to find various bits and pieces of the actual vessel itself. Just look there on top of the boiler, it might be a bit hard to see, but there's actually a set of stairs. And at this time we're finding lots of handrails and deck seats. I hope someone's found a bit of something there. And various fittings that were actually lying around on top of the deck just underneath the mud. And they're actually building up on the pontoon in the background.
On the banks of the Whanganui River, day 6 of the salvage, 11th of January 1993. The section what you're looking at is the salvage team up on the bow of the vessel attaching external flotation. These drums have been welded into rafts and they've been secured by wires to all the hatch frame, the deck frames underneath. All the spaces underneath the vessel have been cleared of all silt and debris. They're basically just full of water at the moment. Working on way down through the middle of the vessel, see the top of the boilers showing, all the engine rooms being cleared. And coming on down, you see the discharge working. The men are working now into the after hatchway. And we can see that this area is completely sound. We're going to investigate the idea of putting a cofferdam on top of the hatch lid and actually try and pumping it out completely, the whole space. Should give us more flotation. We have a diver coming down this afternoon that's going to secure to the outboard side hitching points so we can lash down more of the flotation later on. The tides are really well at the moment and the river's very low, so we're getting a really good...
The job of attaching drums goes on. What we're doing here is we're slowly covering the whole of the foredeck with 44-gallon drums. This gives you some idea of the support and the interest that the project's starting to generate. There's starting to be a steady stream of people to and from the site, all the way along the riverbank where we're working. And it's good to see that sort of support from the Whanganui community. Gilson and Brian are working right at the stern, cleaning out. There's Ian there actually lifting up pieces of decking so we can attach more wires to the deck beams so we can hold those drums down more securely. Here we see our two divers, Ian Jackson and Greg Cox. They've arrived on site this evening because we're having quite a lot of difficulty getting the decking to lift on the outshore side so we can hook extra wires onto it. So they're going to go down and see if they can knock the odd plank out from underneath. And they're just getting the gear on and getting ready and in the water. See the discharge in the background there, still pumping mud out. In the background there we can see Ian and Greg, the two divers, just getting ready to go inside the vessel.
January the 12th, about 10:30 in the morning. Watching now, the men are going along the inboard side of the vessel, right down to the bottom of a turn of a bilge, disturbing all the mud. It's been ejected back out over the side. And that's why we're finding that all the sides are still solid. There's no actual holes below where we've been before. They're all in, the whole internal spaces of the boat have all been cleaned. Starting up forward this morning at low water, we started placing flotation barrels inside the hull. So the barrels you see on deck at the moment, she's got just over 10 ton of positive lift. That'll be happening on her when the drums are covered at high tide today.
We're just Ian Jackson's just going down into the engine room to block off the hole between the engine compartment and the cargo compartment immediately behind it. And what we've done is we've attached a copper dam around that compartment, and we're going to have a crack at pumping it out so we can actually place the flotation drums right inside the vessel.
diver.
Wednesday the 13th of January. The wooden structure you're looking at has been built over the after hatchway. It's a dry hold cofferdam. The idea is we've found that the after deck space and its spaces underneath are pretty well intact. We tried last night pumping out the space and we found we've got two holes. The diver you're looking at is down there now putting a patch over it, and we're going to have another go this morning at sucking all the water out of the after end. They're working on the after end of the ship. They've found her rudder, it's still intact, as well as the steering stock and the chains and leads that used to go.
Hey Mark, a hammer. Oh, hammer.
What we're doing here is we're getting ready to pump this after compartment out again. We think we've blocked up all the holes now, and the guys are just putting sandbags around the bottom edges of it and over a few holes in the deck, and we've set up the ejector inside it and it's hooked up to the fire engine, and what we're going to do is then turn the ejector on, which has a very high rate of pumping, and actually pump it out. See by the colour of the river, there's been a lot of rain up country, and we've been chased out of the job for a day or two. And this is actually what low tide looks like now, and you can't see any of the vessel. So we're just waiting for the river to go down. We haven't had much luck with our pumping of the after command.
Well, here we are. It's January the 20th. It's in the afternoon at low water on the salvage side of the paddle steamer Waimarie. The man you see on the stern of the boat, he's actually holding up the steering chain. The steel rod that's attached to it, that went up the side of the ship up to opposite where the wheel was, and then the chain took it up to the actual steering wheel itself. But that's still attached to the after steering gear, and we've just discovered that the ship's rudder is still in place. So the whole steering gear for the after end of the vessel is still complete. That's it. See, it's still attached. there's not much water in the river at the moment, it's very low, and our tides are going down, so there's plenty of the boat exposed. What you're watching at the moment is the diver going down. He's going to attach more chains to the superstructure to hold the second raft that's just been made and put in on site. These rafts will lift 3.8 ton, and with the two of them on either side of the boiler, we're hoping to displace the weight of the boilers themselves inside the boat. The diver's down on the inside of the hull there. He's working his way and wiring the boat right underneath. He's down past the turn of the bilge and actually underneath the boat. The whole area towards us from him has been excavated. As in yesterday, we found the rudder, and he's had his feet right underneath the boat. You see on board now, they're just giving the diver a hand. He's right down in front of Rex there with the brown shirt on. You see his head, and what he's doing is attaching chains so they can secure the second raft into place. Well, these men have been down here regular all the time. Every low water, there's the same crowd getting on board and doing it. Friday the 22nd on site. What the men are doing today is they're going in through the after little cofferdam there, and we're going to start packing in the plastic flotation. The Venturi you see resting across the top of the woodwork, that's going to be used to suck the water out. We figure this space is still sound, so there shouldn't be any water leaking back into it, and get as much flotation in there today as we can. Moving up to the middle of the boat, you'll see the big red raft on the outboard side that is going to get attached to the outboard side today. Bit of extra lift on that side because it's a lot deeper than the inshore starboard side. Venturi's just been fired up now. So the water you see coming out of the discharge is the water that's inside the boat. They're taking the water level down below the decks. And they're down inside with the torches and that, having a look around to see what they can see. Meanwhile, more plastic barrels arrive. Yeah. The idea of the tow truck here, lying across the bow of the vessel is a great big tree stump, and the tow truck's here to try and pull it, see if we could dislodge it and move it out of the way. The pull's too great for it though, the log's too stuck. Trucks are starting to pull themselves backwards, even with the fire engine attached to the front of the tow truck. So the boys are just having a debate on what the heck we're going to do about this big log that's flying across our...
Here we are, it's the evening of Saturday the 23rd of January, and we're on board the vessel. Boys are re-securing the flotation. Some of our straps and strops gave way last night with the pressure that was under them. So we'll relocate it all and tie it all back down. As you move up the deck, the big pontoon on the upward side, the chains holding that down to the vessel snapped last night in the high tide. So we have to retie that one when the tide gets a bit lower today. Moving on up to a bow, we started putting the vessel under tension on the turfers, and the forward one near the strop actually carried away. So Ian's just resetting all that line now. Earlier on today we were down here, we've got a big air lance made, and that goes right underneath the boat, and we're starting to try and break its actual suction. We reckon there's enough flotation there now to actually lift the weight of what's left of the vessel, around about 38 tonne at the moment. This after hatch you're looking at now, there's 240 containers went into that one yesterday. We actually managed to dry hole it while the river was over the decks. So it still means it's a sound space.
Be on a slab.
Here we are, starting to lance underneath the boat with compressed air, trying to break the suction and help assist the vessel out of its hole. It's very long, so they can push it well underneath the boat. The boat being about 16 feet wide in the middle. We see the project from the river. You can see all the drums and the two copper dams at the rear of the vessel sticking up. We're just turning up river now. We're out on the river aboard the Gwinelda. I'm looking back at the Waimarie from the river again. And gives you quite an idea of how big the Waimarie actually is. We're actually taking a while to sail past this pile of drums which is sticking out of the river. The team are just starting to move back onto the job and start reattaching the drums and pulling them down a bit further and a bit tighter. There's Kevin at the wheel of Gwinelda, Marie in the background. We've got a lot of visitors up on shore there, watching the project. Here's the compressed air, actually the lance is right under the boat and the bubbles are coming up on the other side.
Above the paddle steam of Waimarie, it's 1:15 on January the 26th, 1993, and she's just come out of a hole. We're picking up the slack on the turfers and we've pulled her in about 3 feet so far. She's just hovering just above her hole, so that's our idea for the rest of the program. Just keep working on the turfers and quietly pulling her into the riverbank.
Coffer dams at the back of the vessels are now actually sticking up out of the river. You can just see one there. They're just sticking up out of the river, and at the beginning of the evening they were about 2 foot to 3 feet down under the water at the top of the tide, and they're still actually making water on the tide, and the coffer dams are floating above the surface. So we know that the boat's moved, it's risen up out of its hole, and we've actually managed to pull it backwards. So at low tide we ought to be able to see the Waimarie, and there's a great deal more Waimarie than anyone's been able to see for 40 years.
The 26th, day 23 of the actual salvage operation, and at 12:15 this morning the boat took a lift and strain and we were able to pull her closer into the shore. She's actually floated now and come out of a hole, so she's unstuck, as they say, and that's what you see.
Well, what are you reading there?
She came out about 4 feet and she's slightly lifted, which gives us more room to work as well. We can get down into the spaces now and really get some flotation in her and bring her up level.
And now looking along the Waimarie. Waimarie's now up out of the river and we're looking along from one end to the other, and you can see the decks up near the wooden decks up near the coffer dam. It's actually something to walk on. It's on a bit of a steep angle, but it's quite solid. We can really actually start to look in the side parts of the ship as well. Lou O'Connell standing in front of the fire engine. Lou used to work for the River Services Company and he's been waiting to see the Waimarie for 40 years again. But he's very excited, he's been down here having a look.
There we have the whistle. ship's voice. It turned out that the engine room was dismantled and it was all dropped into the after hold. It was the first time in 40 years this whistle's seen the light of day. We just took it down the road and put it on a compressor and it still works. So there she is, we've got her voice back.
On low tide again, as you can see the vessel has come unstuck and she's been pulled further back up onto the riverbank, exposing more of her port side. She's still painted green with the red boot topping showing. Now what we've done is we've gone into that after hatch and taken out all the previous ballast we put in. Now the deck's above water, we can have a good look inside. And what we've found is a complete engine room. They've dismantled the engine room years ago and dropped everything into the hold. All the copper piping, the handles, everything you can think of that was in the engine room has been recovered from out of that after hatch. The vessel seems reasonably sound. We can't see any daylight getting through, so there's no holes in the hull. So the idea is now just to pack it with as much flotation as we can and start to get the boat prepared to move her up onto higher ground.
We've got quite a good crowd of people here today. They're all having a good look around it. Winery now that you can actually see more of it. The salvage team are restowing the two after compartments in the hope that we get a bit more flotation when the tide comes in. And you can see that Martin's hosing down the decks there and making it a bit more pleasant to walk about on. It's quite nice to have a deck to walk on, to actually have dry feet at low tide. Well, you can really see Waimarie now. We've pulled her back a bit further and right out of the hole. And you can actually see underneath the boat. Right up at the stern we are. This is the stern of the boat. We're now able to get a really good look at it. Here's around the other side on the offshore side. You can see all the drums and things that we've had all tied on all under the water. Still pumping out mud up in the... Now we have a good view of the boat. We're looking right down on top of it and you can get some idea of the number of containers we actually packed on the surface on the outside. And bearing in mind that most of the inside's full of containers. We've managed to move the boat back a bit further out of its hole. Well, we're able to get a really good look inside the boat now. We've come back quite a bit further and we'll probably get our first sighting inside the engine room. Well, as you can see now we've pulled the boat back even still further forward and we can now see the bow and the little winch on the front of the bow, the winch that was used for pulling the boat up the rapids, and you can get a good look right along the boat, right along the side, and you can see where the paddle wheel is on the inshore side has been removed. See all the after deck. We're just about right out of the hole now. Now the 30th of Jan and we've pulled the boat back a long way and we can see inside, actually get inside the engine room when the tide goes away, and so we've decided to start removing some of the machinery to take the load off the hull to make it an easier job manoeuvring it out of the hole in the river. And Emmett Brothers are arriving on site and we've bought two cranes. The boiler's a fairly large piece of equipment, it's fairly heavy, it's full of mud, and they're going to lift it out on shore for us. Gilson's just hooking up the first crane around the boiler. We've got the second crane just coming into line now. We're just going to put that one on the other end and lift it up. We've got the boiler hooked on now, and we're all set for the big lift. It's the first time the Waimarie's boiler's been out of the hole for 90 years, since it was put in 1900. There it is. One Yarrow and Company water tube boiler. With quite a lot, large number of parts missing. It's coming out all in one piece. The team's undone the bolts in the bottom of it from down below, and the cranes are lifting it off its beds. Just lowering the boiler down now. This is the first piece of equipment, of the major equipment that's on board in the engine room, that we've been able to bring ashore, so it's a bit of a step forward. We're going to also lift off the port engine when we've got the boiler safely lowered down. Well, here it is, the port engine, part of the business of making the ship go ahead, coming out of the boat. It's been quite surprising, the guys down there have been able to undo most of the bolts, and you wouldn't think so. It's still covered with a fair bit of mud. There's a lot of grease and oil, which has probably preserved the nuts and threads, and that's why they're coming undone. Well, as you can see, there's been quite a lot of changes. We've moved the boat further back, completely out of a hole, and she's actually on another beach further down the river from where she was before. And of course, we've removed quite a bit of her machinery, and that's lightened up the load. And the boat's actually floating at the moment. We're just waiting for the tide to go away for her to settle down on the bottom again. And we're going to restow a lot of the stuff inside her and improve her capability of floating, so we can take her around to the beach behind the Whanganui River Boat Centre and lift her out of the river. Well, here we have the port engine down at the River Boat Centre, and we're actually getting ready to remove the nuts and bolts and try and pull it apart and get the water and the mud out of it before the air gets at it and it starts to deteriorate. So we're busy watching Laurie and Rex in the disassembly process. Well, now the tide's gone out, and we've got a shot here of the boat. It's actually sitting on the beach, with the beach that's right out of its hole, and we're starting to have a good look at it and decide how we're going to stiffen up some parts of it before we float it around to the other beach for the final slipping and lifting out of the river. We've got a few breaks on the side of the hull to actually stiffen and repair, just to make it a bit safer. As you can see, we've been fairly busy preparing our temporary slipway. We've now actually got the rail sets on the riverbank and extending out into the river. And what we're going to do is we're going to put a steel plate on top of these, each one of these, and then we're actually going to pull that. And when we pull that, we'll actually have the boat sitting on top of it, and we'll pull the boat in as well. So we've done quite a lot of work getting the slip. What we're doing here is we're repairing all the splits in the sides of the hull to make it very stable, or as stable as we can possibly get it, for the float round to the where we're going to slip it. And this is the beginning of a very busy period. Everyone worked really hard here. We took out all the flotation and restowed it, and cleaned out all the remaining compartments that were full of mud, and got it into the to float as level as we could possibly get it to float, so we'd have less difficulties putting it on the slip and actually pulling.